difficult stretch for the Lynx, but now their travel eases up, their schedule eases up, and they are hoping the turnaround begins tonight against the New York Liberty at Target Center. 3 weeks ago in New York, Maya Moore hit a go-ahead three-pointer with 20 seconds to play. That was the shot that sealed it, gave Minnesota a dramatic win over the Liberty. Tonight is the rematch in Minneapolis. Good evening from Target Center. I'm Marnie Gellner along with Leah Bielsen. Leah, we have not seen this group have quite the stretch like this. We saw them have some difficulties toward the end of last season, the regular season, but never quite like this. This is uncharted territory. How do you see the Lynx responding to this?
Well, Lynx fans are definitely a bit uneasy right now, but the Lynx had a great week of practice where they took it back to the basics. And after that week, they're saying they're ready to go. They understand the importance of this must-win game.
And they have gotten solid production, consistent production from their two best players in Maya Moore and Sylvia Fowles.
Well, Sylvia is getting double and triple team each and every night, yet she still has seven double-doubles on the season. She's been a monster on the boards and effective under pressure. And Maya has been doing all the little things well for this team, including shooting the ball well for the last four games. She's been knocking down threes. Her percentage from beyond the arc, 41.7%.
The Lynx will continue to need that solid production from those two players. And tonight they meet a team with a new head coach, but it's someone who is very familiar to Lynx fans. Katie Smith, she played seven seasons with the Lynx, and she's here for the first time as a head coach. In the early 2000s, she was the face of the franchise, scored over 6,000 WNBA points, won two championships with the Detroit Shock. She's a member of the Hall of Fame. And Leah, Katie Smith has a lot to work with in the Liberty, and in particular, their star, Tina Charles.
Well, Tina Charles is a five-time All-Star. She's second in the league in scoring, and she is a dominant, strong presence that can beat you in so many different ways. The best way to defend her is to not let her get the ball. She's a great rebounder, and she plays with a lot of energy. She will give the Lynx trouble tonight.
Tina Charles finished second in MVP voting last season, second to Minnesota's Sylvia Fowles. Coming up, as the Lynx navigate some choppy waters, they have found a bright spot in the backcourt. How Alexis Jones is making the most of her opportunity after this.
She beams. She glows. Colorful mystery and adventure. She's a guide. She's a route. A story and a song. She's this day. She's this moment. She's this place. And she belongs to you. Only in Minnesota.
Slumberland's Dream Team introduces the incredible, livable, adjustable bed. It's more than a bed. It's a livable piece of furniture where all those cozy little ups and downs of life are shared.
Isn't that the guy
who sold us our bed?
We've got one for every mattress, all at the lowest price around.
Hey, Mortensen. How you doing?
Did he just
wave at us?
The incredible, livable, adjustable bed. Only at Slumberland. It's a good life.
Introducing the Budweiser Freedom Reserve, a limited edition red lager with a light, hoppy aroma, a toasted malt taste, and a hint of molasses. Proudly brewed in support of veterans by Budweiser's own veterans. Available this summer for a limited time only.
The Lynx are ready to settle in at home. They'll play six of their next nine games at Target Center, starting tonight with the New York Liberty. Second-year guard Alexis Jones has played some big minutes in June. 25 minutes last Saturday at Connecticut, 28 in L.A., two games before that. And Leah, A.J.'s gotten some opportunities this month that she's taken advantage of.
Well, we saw last year in the playoffs that she could hit big shots at critical times, and now that she's getting more minutes this season, we're going to see that she can get more confidence. confident. What we're seeing from her in practice is that she can hit big threes. We're starting to see those now in the games. This is a dynamic player who's also strong on the defensive end. But this young player needs reps. She has to get in the game more, get that confidence, because what we're seeing is the more she's in, the better she is.
She played a lot in the last game Saturday against Connecticut. In those 25 minutes, had 9 points and 4 assists. So we'll see if Jones can continue to make an impact off the bench as Minnesota tries to stabilize. It's a critical game against the New York Liberty, and it is up next from Target Center.
Introducing the Budweiser Freedom Reserve, a limited edition red lager with a light hoppy aroma, a toasted malt taste, and a hint of molasses. Proudly brewed in support of veterans by Budweiser's own veterans. Available this summer for a limited time only.
Season, and it starts tonight at Target Center against New York. The Liberty is 3-5 this season. Last year was the number one team in the East, and this year has a brand new head coach, but someone who is very familiar to Lynx fans here. Katie Smith, the first superstar for the Lynx, the first star player who led the team in nearly every statistical category when she played here in the early 2000s. 7 seasons in a Lynx uniform. Katie takes over for the Liberty after Bill Laimbeer left to go coach the Las Vegas Aces. And Katie's been on his staff for a few seasons now. She's got a pretty good team that, similar to Minnesota, is struggling to find its footing. Bria Hartley and Javante Zellis in the starting five tonight. Marissa Coleman, leading scorer, Tina Charles, does a little bit of everything, and the outstanding rookie, Kia Vaughn. Cheryl Reeve held a mini training camp this week on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday for her team with no games, trying to find out how her team will respond to that. She challenged them big time this week, saying that it is time now for the response. And if we don't get it starting Saturday, she said, I don't know what we're doing. The Lynx are focused on getting their legs under them. Lindsay Whalen, Tanisha Wright is in the starting five tonight. Simone Augustus is out with a hamstring injury. More Brunson and fouls. Leah, what do you have for your keys tonight against the Liberty?
All righty. Well, we'll kick things off here with the Minnesota Lynx. And with the Lynx, it's going to be about team defense. We have to be in sync, and they have to communicate in winning mentality. They got to get back to their winning ways and to believe they can do it. And for the Liberty, they bench play. This is a team that has some great bench players. They have to get the bench players out and going early. And then offensive balance. The New York Liberty, they tend to put a lot of pressure on Tina Charles to score most of the points. They have to get everybody in that starting lineup a lot of opportunities to score the ball.
A little bit of a change in that starting five for the first time all season. Simone Augustus is out, so we'll see Tanisha Wright, who played the last 2 seasons with the New York Liberty. The opening tip at Target Center goes out of bounds. It'll be Liberty basketball. Javante Zellis will inbound to Bria Hartley. Minnesota has not played in a week, not since the loss at Connecticut. And so Cheryl Reeve gave her players Monday and Tuesday off, and then they had that mini training camp on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, trying to just clean things up, get back to the basics, get straightened out, and we'll see what the response is tonight from Minnesota. Good defensive possession as Coleman misses the first shot.
Well, the team has started off with a difficult record. Here's Maya Moore doing her thing.
Maya answers on the other end. First possession for Minnesota's a basket.
They've been on the road for so much time, so that was well-needed rest that they had, those 2 days off, and then a nice time to sit down and practice and really work on some things.
Kia Vaughn misses And so far, it's been one and done for the Liberty in their first two shots. Yeah, the Lynx played six of their first, or their last seven games on the road. They started at home for two, and then they went on the road for three, home for one. On the road for three, back home for one. Whalen. And that's a big sign for Lindsey Whalen to score early. She did not score in the last game at Connecticut.
Well, that'll be a huge deal.
Bria Hartley with the response.
For Minnesota, if Lindsey Whalen can get this team going, even if she doesn't have to score a lot, because Lindsey doesn't need to score a lot, but if she can get the team in the flow of the offense and then add a few here and there, that should be enough.
Here's Moore, and that is someone that the Lynx have counted on. Moore and Fowles have continued to pull the weight for Minnesota. Fowles from the baseline.
That's a good sign for Minnesota when you see Sylvia Fowles being pulled out on the baseline like that, able to hit that little mid-range shot.
Zealous. And again, a one-shot try for New York.
The last time Minnesota met up with New York, the Lynx won the boards by 10. So that was a huge piece for today's game, as they have to win the battle of the boards.
Hartley. Now guarded by Moore. Bria Hartley kicks it out to Zealous. And around the baseline. Baseline two up and in for Kiavon.
Sylvia Fowles gets there just a second too late.
Vaughn is one of the players that did not play in the May 25th game at New York, the game that Minnesota won after the big Maya Moore three-pointer with about 20 seconds left to play. Tough scud shot there. There were four players, Brittany Boyd, Epiphany Prince, Sugar Rogers, and Kia Vaughn. Four critical players for New York. This is almost a completely different team outside of Tina Charles and Kia Nurse.
And this is only
on again.
The second game that they've had that full team all together. So it's I feel like New York's still getting used to having their rotations and what that's going to look like.
Boyd missed time with an Achilles, Prince with a concussion, Sugar Rogers with a knee injury, and Vaughn's overseas with her team. Tanisha Wright drives and scores, making an impact in the starting lineup tonight.
And that's a big deal for Minnesota, having Simone Augustus on the bench.
Charles, and she will shoot from distance. But Cheryl Reeve said before the game, that's not such a bad thing. If Tina Charles wants to launch from long distance, the Lynx will probably let her until she connects on a few. Fowles with only Vaughn guarding her. Underneath, what a beautiful move by Sylvia Fowles.
It's a good read by Fowles, seeing the mismatch and the height advantage that she had there.
Zealous. Here's Coleman. And now Charles, guarded by Brunson. Tina Charles from the baseline. Man, was that a tough shot. Tina Charles tied for the league lead at 21.9 points per game.
In contested shots, Tina Charles had a hand in her face. Brunson did a nice job defensively, and she still hits.
Moore cuts through the lane, gets the basketball from right, and is fouled by Zealous.
Nice start to this game.
Danielle Robinson checks in for Minnesota as Lindsey Whalen takes a seat on the bench. Robinson to right. Tanisha Wright, nice moves, but couldn't finish, and then it's out of bounds, but Minnesota will retain possession.
It'll be interesting to see what Coach Reeve does here with her rotation. She talked this week in practice about tightening things up with the rotation.
Give a go with Robinson. She'll kick it out. Right? No, but Fowles with the offensive rebound and put back.
Fowles keeps the ball up nice and high so no one else can get near it.
She does it so well, and Fowles has had to deal with double teams, triple teams, sometimes quadruple teams. And she's still managing to put up the numbers. Take a foul away from the basketball. Brunson there just before the whistle. A quick 12-9 start for Minnesota.
I grew up in Miami with three older brothers and an older sister. They definitely pushed me towards basketball, and they helped me get better.
How do you stop Sylvia Fowles?
I was eager to learn because I always wanted to impress. It just made me a better person. I always felt like I can do anything. That's just that drive that keeps me going. Like, how can I be better than I was last year?
Denied by Sylvia Fowles.
I'm here to work.
Summers can be hectic. Lynx point guard Lindsay Whalen here to challenge you to improving as a basketball player. The Timberwolves and Lynx Basketball Academy camps are designed to improve your game. Spend part of your summer with our awesome staff. Visit TimberwolvesBasketballAcademy.com for locations near you. Go Lynx!
Minnesota in the first quarter. Sylvia Fowles has started the game 3 for 3 with 6 points. And Leah, Minnesota's been effective in the paint.
Well, the plan is always to go to Sylvia early and often. She's done so well. It's a double team. It doesn't matter. She has a lot of different moves. Good job at reading the defense. Keeps it up nice and high so no one else can get near it. Comes out strong, needing Sylvia Fowles, needing a little bit of help from her teammates when she's getting double and triple team.
As a team, Minnesota has 10 paint points. New York, none. Danielle Robinson ran into a screen and drew a foul from New York. That'll be Kia Vaughn with the foul. Just look at the screen.
Wow. Yeah, that's running into a brick wall.
First turnover of the game. Alexis Jones, we talked about her a little bit tonight already. Getting some early minutes. Brunson can't connect on the three-pointer, but Rebecca Brunson has been good from three, shooting 45% from the floor overall, 50% from three coming in. She'd made 8 of 16 this season before that miss.
Yeah, they want her to take that shot this week in practice. They said when you're there and you're open, take it.
Knocked away by Maya Moore, forcing a turnover and then nearly losing the dribble. Brunson this time into the lane, a little floater. Back-to-back baskets. Actually, one basket by Rebecca Brunson on back-to-back shots.
And that's a good basket for Rebecca Brunson coming off of that air ball, getting aggressive and getting into the lane where she knows she can score.
Zelis kicks it out. Long three-point try from the baseline. That was Brittany Boyd. Boyd had missed most of this season, missed almost all of last season after a torn Achilles. Jones drives the baseline. In fact, Boyd hurt her Achilles and tore it in a game against Minnesota last May 18th. So she only made it to May 18th, missed all of last season after that, and didn't make her season debut until June 5th. She played 4 games this season.
Yeah, that's a crazy story.
It's a tough injury anytime you hear Achilles.
It's definitely a fall down low. And I think both teams, though, have come out real aggressively in this game. A nice start to this game. I think both teams understand that it's important. New York needs a win after the loss that they had against the Aces. And, of course, the Lynx would like to protect their home court.
Moore drives to the left side and kisses it off the glass. Second basket of the game.
That was another conversation at practice this week, getting Maya Moore involved in the offense earlier.
An answer, though, from Epiphany Prince.
Prince was one of the players who did not play in the May 25th game. It fouls, picks up a double team as soon as she got the ball, but that's not enough to stop her. 4-4 from the floor. Before that last basket, New York had turned it over on three of its last four possessions. And there again, a deflection, which is exactly what Cheryl Reeve wants to see and what Katie Smith is finding out drives her nuts as a head coach.
Yeah, we
think fiery. And it was so quick, you know, this is the first time I've seen Katie in person since she's been a head coach. And it's like she just is a coach now. She feels like a coach and she's fiery and doing all the things that head coaches do.
like sweat it out, point, and throw their arms up.
Exactly.
And question everything. It is odd, though, to see that transition. But Katie's been here. She was the associate head coach last season for this Liberty team. Oh, what a shot. What an attempt, anyway, from Brittany Boyd. Good defense by Minnesota. Robinson racing the other way, and she's fouled. Danielle Robinson, you see the speed that she has.
And that was the reason that Danielle Robinson was brought into this Lynx team, for her ability to push the pace, get up and down the court. And it's right away when she gets the ball, she is going. Her teammates trying to keep up with her. She gets herself to the free throw line.
She's the fastest player in the NBA by my count. There's not an exact measure. They don't have a race for that, but
you mean the WNBA?
WNBA, I'm sorry. She's the fastest player in the W. She might be one of the fastest players in the NBA. I mean, we don't know. She hasn't gone toe-to-toe. A 10-2 run for the Lynx. Another three-point try. That's Kia Nurse, the rookie out of UConn, who has been one of the brightest young stories in the WNBA.
Yeah, she has looked very good this season.
Lynetta Kaiser corked it. And the Lynx have played a lot of their bench already. Cheryl Reeve played four subs in this first quarter. Kia Nurse was the 10th pick of the draft, averages 13 points per game, shoots 41%. Really adjusting well to life in the WNBA.
Well, and I think she is a bit of a surprise. You know, she's the 10th pick, as you said, and she comes in and she's making an impact right away. She's a great three-point shooter and also just has a real confidence on the court already, just as a rookie. So this is a player I'm interested to see when she's going to move her way into that starting lineup.
They'll jump it up after that. What do you call it, wedgie or cork? Or what is the proper term to that ball that just sticks on the side of the rim?
I'm not sure.
Also, notice for New York, number 17, that's Amanda Zowie B, the former Golden Gopher. Fouls, offensive rebound, and another basket. She's a perfect 5 of 5.
Sylvia Falls just physically so strong down low. If she gets that rebound, you're not going to knock the ball out of her hands.
Danielle Robinson and Brittany Boyd got tangled up. And there's a look at Amanda Zowie B, who second pick of the draft back in 2015 and played for the Golden Gophers from Stockholm, Sweden.
It's good to see her back in a uniform, not a Gophers uniform, a WNBA uniform. She looks great. She's definitely in great shape.
Here's Prince. Tiffany Prince with 8 seconds on the shot clock. Prince now with 5, still with the basketball, drives baseline. Nice pass, great pass, and ends up in the hands of Kia Stokes. There are 3 Kias on this New York Liberty team. Nurse and Stokes and Vaughn. Jones kicks it out to Chilia Zandalasini. Offensive rebound, Lynetta Kaiser, who then lost it out of bounds. Zandalasini has come on, too, and started to see some bigger minutes here in the last handful of games.
Yeah, you really want to see these players do well when they get in for these last couple minutes in the quarters, because it's important. Coach Reeve right now is deciding which players are actually going to play throughout the season. And so when you come in, you have to accomplish something.
Tammy Fegg-Bentley checked in just at that last dead ball. Sylvia Fowles checked out, get a little extra rest between quarters. four on the shot clock. Robinson did not pull the trigger. Zandalasini does. Tichy for two just inside the arc.
Zandalasini is a player that Coach Reeve and her staff really think highly of.
Boyd picks up her dribble. Here's Prince now. Back to Boyd. Brittany Boyd hits the three. New York takes more three-pointers than any team in the league, but they're fourth in makes and eighth in percentage. So they'll take a lot, but they won't always make a lot.
Right, and she was wide open, Boyd, right there. Had time to think about it and rethink about it. But, yeah, they're going to take a lot of three-pointers. You still got to get in their face, even though they know they're going to miss a lot of them.
Final seconds of the first quarter. A.J. Alexis Jones gains the contact, hits the basket. A tough two from A.J. Stolen by Zandalasini. She got the inbound pass, and she hits a two at the buzzer. What a way to finish the first quarter for Minnesota. Cecilia Zandalasini stole the inbound pass after Alexis Jones made the shot, and that is 4 points in the blink of an eye for Minnesota. Great defense, great instincts, great finish. There's the basket by Alexis Jones. There's the steal by Tchetchi and the basket.
Inside us all beats the heart of an athlete. Determined to succeed. We push, we fight, we sacrifice. Sometimes we fall short. Sometimes we just fall, but we get back up stronger than before. This is more than a game. This is our goal.
Germany may as well be the group of death. They're a precision-tuned defense-destroying machine. But Chicharito and El Tri are ready to take care of business. It's the Uber team versus the underdog. The power versus the passion. Germany versus Mexico, tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern on FS1.
Hey, dads, here's your perfect excuse to break out that ugly tie. Grab the family and join us on Father's Day for the second annual Star Tribune Ugly Tie 5K Fun Run at Father Hennepin Park, followed by a post-race party. All participants receive a finisher's medal and an awesome T-shirt. And there's a kid's half-K, too. Plus, stick around for the Stone Arch Bridge Festival to finish out an incredible day of fun. Register now at startribune.com/uglytie5K.
On Pride Night at Target Center, Lynx fans have a lot to be proud of after that first quarter. The 28 points is the most the Lynx have had in a first quarter this season. And here's how it ended, with Alexis Jones getting this driving layup, and then Cecilia Zandalasini, they call her Tchetchi, stole the inbounds pass, took a dribble, fired before the buzzer, and 4 points in the matter of just a couple of seconds. That is a huge lift to end a quarter, Leah.
It's a huge lift for this team who is trying to work in young players to their lineups, and those young players are starting to step up. So that's a huge deal for this entire team. And one of the differences we're seeing in this game is that the Lynx have really done a good job inside.
Well, the basket counted, and they are saying the basket counts, and it from Temi Fegg-Bentley. We're about 18 people standing in front of us, so trying to sort it all out. But yes, basket counts from Temi Fegg-Bentley.
Well, then that goes to right what I was saying, is that the Lynx are doing a great job of getting the ball down low inside and then also popping it back out, and their perimeter players are hitting the shots. The inside-outside game working for the Lynx.
Fegg-Bentley converts the three-point play. That was two more points in the paint for Minnesota. 22 in the game compared to 2 for New York. Lynx are just dominating inside. And just as I speak, New York tries to answer with two more from Bria Hartley.
Bria Hartley is no doubt the most versatile player on New York's team. She can score in a lot of different ways, and You have to know where she is on the court at all times.
Waylon tried to thread a pass. Xander Lucini was there after the deflection to keep Minnesota's possession. And what a move by Feg Benley. Great pass by Chechi. Everything was just smooth, like it was planned that way.
Yeah, very finesseful. Feg Benley showing that she can take a couple steps to get to the basket.
Following the shot there, Epiphany Prince went up, got undercut just as she let it go.
Basket's good. Foul's called.
Good job holding her composure there. And Epiphany Prince will have a shot at a three-point play. The Lynx have really stretched this lead here. The reigning champs are back, and so is College Night, presented by U.S. Bank. For select weeknight home games, college students can get lower-level tickets for $10 by using a valid .edu email address online. Visit linksbasketball.com/college to get your tickets now. Three-point play from Epiphany Prince. Makes it a 14-point game at Target Center. Feg Benley. A little strong. Xander Lucini, look how high she skied for the rebound. Ends up knocking it off of Tina Charles.
That's the effort that Coach Reeve is looking for, the little extra efforts. You know, using your hands to deflect balls.
Tanisha Wright back in as Alexis Jones checks out. A good stint for Alexis Jones, too. And she's kind of had feast or famine minutes over the last couple of weeks. Waylon nearly threw it away on the pass to Wright. Tanisha Wright had to make a great play just to save that ball. And Brunson tracks it down. Great hustle out of this Lynx team in the first half. Waylon can't get the reverse layup. Brunson offensive board and put it back. There it is. And the crowd loves the effort and the second effort and the third effort.
Second chance points by Minnesota, 8. New York, 0. So there it is.
Zowie B hands it off. Hartley converts.
A quick first step by Hartley.
Yeah, Bria Hartley has shot 50% or better in 3 of her last 4 games.
Yeah, she's so quick defensively as well.
Feg Benley corrals that one on a tough pass from Waylon.
Feg Benley was a player that Coach Reeve had said had a great week in practice. She really thought she had done some things and had some confidence build up.
Steal by Minnesota. Timmy Feg Benley already has 7 points in this game. In 4 minutes. Brunson connects on a 3-pointer.
Big shot for Minnesota.
Man, Cheryl Reeve was wondering how her team was going to respond to this week. She's got to be happy with what she's seen so far. 40-21. Minnesota is absolutely rolling. Already a career high for Feg Benley with the 7 points and a big 19-point lead.
Mom and Dad got a new car with the extra third row seats. They think it's theirs. Look at them. They have no idea. It's not theirs. It's mine. Mine.
The new RX350L with 3 rows for 7 passengers.
Are you excited about your baby sister coming?
Experience space for the unexpected with the Lexus RXL, part of the RX family. See Lexus of Wayzata and Lexus of Maplewood.
Lynx have turned back the clock here in this first half, leading 40-21 over the Liberty. Rebecca Brunson has come up big with 7 points so far in this game.
Well, Brunson is that player that is always going to hustle and do whatever she has to do to score the ball. But she, in this game, has been effective scoring. She's down low, and then also she's pulling out and hitting big threes. Brunson has had a slow start in this season, so to see her getting rolling here is a very good thing.
And had a quiet night the last game, last Saturday, against Connecticut. Sugar Rogers, the former Minnesota Lynx player, connects on a three-pointer.
That's something the Lynx need to worry about.
Yeah, Sugar can get hot in a hurry. She's shooting 40% from three this season. We're talking about Rebecca Brunson. Stolen away, though. And here is Rogers controlling it. Moore fouls her at half court. I was going to finish my thought on Brunson, which was the fact that last Saturday at Connecticut, she only had 4 points. She only shot one time. 1 for 1 with 4 points, 2 rebounds, and that's a very quiet night for Rebecca Brunson. So to see her respond like this already in the first half with 7 is a big answer.
It is a big answer, and I felt like, I know we've talked already a lot about this week of practice, but she was one of the players I thought that was really emphasized in how hard she was needing to work to get back to how she wants to play.
A good defense by Brunson on Tina Charles. Whalen pushes the pace. Goes baseline, finds a little seam, and looks for Brunson.
Now that is the first turnover, I believe, is that the second one? Okay, second turnover for the Lynx, which has been an issue for the Lynx all season long. So two at this point, not a huge issue.
And they've been on back-to-back possessions, too.
That's an issue.
Charles again defended by Brunson. And that is a great matchup. Charles short. Tanisha Wright with the rebound. Wright is in the starting lineup tonight while Simone Augustus rests a sore hamstring. Rogers. This is where Minnesota has had trouble turning the ball over. It's been too often. Bria Hartley converts.
And Liberty do a great job of taking advantage of the turnover, getting on the scoreboard. And the Liberty are a team that can get up and down the court.
And the Lynx average 16 turnovers per game, which is a hair under 15.6. But that's the most of any team in the WNBA. And that is what Cheryl Reeve was stressing so much at practice, too, this week. The Lynx still lead it by 14 over the Liberty.
Every day, nearly 100 Americans die in car crashes.
Please make it home safe.
25%
of all car crashes involve a cell phone.
Please make it home safe. This message brought to you by Federated Mutual Insurance Company.
It's in the air, on the breeze, in the hush, in the roar. There's something happening here. Don't miss a second. Only in Minnesota.
The Lynx lead the Liberty by 14 at Target Center. Tomorrow, live coverage of the FIFA World Cup continues at 9 a.m. as Thomas Müller and defending champion Germany battle Chicharito and Mexico in group play. Then Brazil faces off with Switzerland at noon. Catch all the action on FS1 or stream it all live on the Fox Sports app. Those are accurate pronunciations, by the way. I listened to those in an app so that I could say that correctly. Müller.
Very nice job.
Moore. Three-point try. Pushing the pace, it's Shavante Zelis. Zelis comes off the screen. A lot of contact on that screen, and Shavante hits the two.
Maya Moore got hung up on it.
New York is showing signs of life here in the second quarter, fighting back after being down by as many as 19. Tanisha Wright, who played for the Liberty each of the last two seasons. Right behind the back. Fouled. But with objection, fouled by Kia Vaughn.
Ball kind of bailed her out there as well. She's doing a little too much dribbling, gets herself kind of stuck.
Hey, Lynx fans, come and join Prowl at Target Center on June 29th for Prowl's birthday when the Lynx take on the Dream. Make sure to arrive early to get your photo taken with Prowl and all of Prowl's friends. Visit LynxBasketball.com now to get your tickets to this birthday celebration. Tanisha Wright, starting for the first time this season. Simone Augustus day-to-day with the hamstring. Knocked out of bounds. Actually, a foul. Tina Charles. And there is Simone. And Cheryl Reeve was talking before the game about the hamstring and just saying, you know, we thought she'd be ready, but it's nothing that we think is going to linger. It's just sort of something that she needs to take care of, and hopefully we'll have her for the next game.
Yeah, I think that's a good decision.
On fire is the word. I was looking for the term. I knew I wrote it down. Said right now that hamstring is just a little too on fire to play. Another putback by Sylvia Fowles. She is 6 of 6 from the floor with 12 points and 3 rebounds. And another rebound for Syl. Moore picks up Tina Charles as the defender kicks it out to Danielle Robinson. And that time it's a foul on Brunson. Offensively, Rebecca Brunson. Off ball foul. Kia Vaughn on that last possession, by the way, when she picked up her foul, it was the third of the game for Vaughn. Hartley kicks it out. Zelis. Holding the ball, guarded by Maya Moore. Now gets free for two, just inside the arc.
Yeah, it's a great screen. Comes off wide open. Once again, Lynx get hung up.
Brunson will try another three. She already hit one in this game. Can't get that one. Sugar Rogers pushes it up the court. Charles. Tina Charles hits the three-pointer. She's shooting 21% coming in from three, but she's taken 33. 7 of 33. That's a lot for a 6'4 center.
Yeah.
That's a lot of threes.
She does. She's going to take a lot of shots to get her points.
Tanisha Wright crosses half court and calls a timeout. I was asking Cheryl Reeve before the game about New York. Because they shoot a lot of threes, but they don't always make a lot. And here's another look at Tina Charles. Was she behind the line? Yeah, clearly, that's a three. And in particular, how do you defend Tina Charles? Do you sort of let New York make a few before you stretch out your D? And Cheryl said, you know, we know that they don't make a lot. They're eighth in the league in percentage, but first in number of threes. But she said, we're not going to let them just sit and barrage, because if they start connecting, I mean, that... You just bury yourself so quickly. Tina Charles is the one player, she said, we might let her try to beat us. If she wants to get three-point happy, we might take that.
And I think what she's also saying with that with Tina Charles is Tina Charles is going to try to get most of her points in the paint and down low, and that's, you know, she's going to get those points.
And, so, yeah, you want to... She's so tough to defend.
Right, exactly. So if she's going to beat us on the three-point line, so be it. Let her beat you know, let her, like we're Sugar Rogers, though, you better have a hand in her face at all times, because we do expect to get beat by Sugar Rogers on that three-point line.
This season, the Lynx are trying to repeat as WNBA champions, something that they have never done and something that only the Houston Comets and LA Sparks have done, and it hasn't been done since 2002. So for 15 consecutive years, we have had a different WNBA champion from year to year. Sometimes the same team, the Lynx in 11, 13, 15, 17.
That is correct.
We got to put an even year in there, and why not 2018?
Well, it does speak to just how difficult that is to repeat year in and year out, or just once to repeat. It's, oh, there's Maya.
Maya Moore with a tough contested shot. Moore, 3 of 4 here in this first half.
And I think even with the high expectations everyone always has with the Minnesota Lynx, and as we see them trying to work through the struggles they're having this season, we know they're a good team.
I'm sorry, Lee, I was about to call a travel, and the officials didn't call it, so I jumped off my seat a little bit.
Charles, and a top two.
And here's Robinson. Loves to push the pace. Zanda Lucini, who had a great stint when she first checked into the game. Wright tries to feed it to Sylvia Fowles, and there's a turnover.
Yeah, that's frustrating, Matt.
Minnesota gets it right back with Robinson. She's got Wright with her. Danielle will take it herself.
I feel like Robinson's getting more and more comfortable on this team, knowing when to attack the basket, knowing when to dish it to her teammates.
Stokes off the rim. Kia Stokes. Here's a look at Danielle Robinson.
One of the things Coach Reeves said she wanted from Danielle Robinson, better reads, knowing when to do what. This she knew, to just attack and lays it in.
And players like Robinson, who are so quick, there's a gamble that goes with it. When do you go for the steal? When is it worth it to gamble? When is it not worth it? And that's a balancing act. It's something, kind of that fine line that a lot of those players have to walk. The lob to Fowles. No call the first time, a foul the second time. I'm guessing this will be on Sugar Rogers.
And Coach Reeve was in the official's ear that time saying, look at how she's getting beat up down there. That's Sylvia Fowles I'm speaking of, because there was definitely a couple of other options that they could have called.
Still has made 5 of her 6 shots in the paint. She's 6 of 7 overall. She had that baseline jumper early on. Alexis Jones back in. She'll give Danielle Robinson a little breather. Robinson gets a high five from Cheryl Reeve and a lot of fives from the bench. Fowles, in her last game in Connecticut, had a double-double, 20 points, 14 rebounds. 55th time in her career she's had a 20-10 game. Hartley keeps the dribble, try to go to Charles, and a whistle off the ball. Offensive, that was Tina Charles trying to get position to get that pass. Officials called Charles for the foul. Katie Smith does not agree.
Proving that she's fitting in right as a head coach.
I know it. It's just so seamless to make that transition. There's Amanda Zawi B giving Tina Charles a break. Charles has 3 fouls now. Jones with 1:45 left in the first half. The Lynx led by as many as 19 points before New York started chipping away. Moore off the rim. Rogers fell to the ground trying to get that rebound. And it rolls out of bounds. That'll be Minnesota ball. And Cheryl Reeve gave a big fist pump after that forced turnover.
She likes the hustle. She likes the aggressiveness. Those are the small things that she thought was missing at the start of this season. This player's getting down on the floor, scrapping for the ball.
Moore goes for it. Kia Stokes was the last one to touch it. And we've seen Sylvia Fowles gets them up. Fowles, she is a character. She is one of my favorite players to ever wear a Lynx uniform, just with that personality.
Agreed.
She's got the braids back, too. I feel like Sill's back. She's got that.
You like the braids best, don't you?
I feel like she just, it's so her. I don't know if it was because she dominated so much last season. She was the MVP, and that's how we saw her.
Yeah,
that was the look. And then this season, she had the short hair, and it was a huge difference. And we saw the team go through some struggles, and Sill didn't look like Sill, and now she's back.
And I'm sure that she'll never be able to get rid of him again.
I'm not saying it's all the brains, Leah. I'm just saying it feels right. Something
agreed
about tonight feels right, but that pass did not.
Yeah, my Morb's gone. Was that me?
And Tanisha Wright knew it right after she threw it, too, by the expression on her face.
And Tanisha Wright doing a pretty good job in here for Simone Augustus, but definitely having a little bit of communication issues as she's trying to learn how to get the ball into fouls, where to pass it to who. It's a finesse thing, and you got to play with people to get that.
Zowie B with the three-pointer. Amanda Zowie B had shot 14 threes coming into this game. So the bigs for New York, not afraid to stretch it out.
Liberty doing a nice job on the three-point line, trying to chip away at this lead.
Yep, 5 of 9 from three. Minnesota's 1 of 6, but Maya Moore has a chance for a three-point play. They'll take it that way as well.
Many different ways that Maya Moore scores the basketball, putting it on the ground, leaning in, using her body, which allows her to get to the free throw line.
Number 23, Maya Moore.
An 84% free throw shooter. Maya's averaging 18 points per game, and that is point number 9 for Maya tonight. 43 seconds to go. Rhea Hartley with the basketball, guarded by Alexis Jones. Offensive foul. Amanda Zowie B used the elbows when she turned around. And Minnesota's got New York a little bit flustered that they've had a few off-ball fouls, a few fouls on screens, or fouls like that on Zowie B.
That's a big turnover right there for New York.
Jones takes the shot. Moore nearly had the rebound right off of Maya's fingertips.
That's a good look for Jones. That shot could have easily fallen, and I'm pretty sure those are the looks that Cheryl Reeve wants from her. She just has to start hitting them.
About 3 second difference between the game clock and shot clock. The Lynx have a couple fouls to give. And just gave one right there. That's the fourth. Actually, it said 2 team fouls. Now it says 4 up on the board. So Minnesota no longer has a foul to give. Okay.
Did she touch her?
Well, I don't think Alexis Jones actually touched Bria Hartley. I think Bria Hartley's momentum just carried her over the line. And that's exactly what Cheryl Reeve is going to argue.
That's like a tiny
not a foul, but I guess, you know, if you don't expect Hartley to fall like that, so I guess maybe in...
She sold it,
and in the official's mind, that Byron Jarrett making that call, that you think that must have happened, I guess. That's the third foul on Jones, and so Danielle Robinson will come in and play the final 14.4 seconds. Hartley hits the free throw. See if the Lynx can get off a quality shot here before halftime. Robinson gets it to the corner. And Trishy Zandalasini hits a big three-pointer. Zandalasini's had a great first half. The clock will run out. And Minnesota closes it with an exclamation point. A season high. 54 points scored in the first half. And Cecilia Zandalasini had a couple of buzzer-beating baskets. One at the end of the first quarter, one at the end of the second quarter here. The Lynx finished on a 34-6 advantage in the paint in the first half.
Definitely a breakout game for Zandalasini. And
look at
their teammates appreciate her.
The bench reacting. What a great finish to the half. Rebecca Brunson had 7 points in that first half. Rebecca joins us now. That was quite a way to end. How much of a lift can you guys get from the way that you played in this first half and the way you just finished?
Oh, my gosh. First of all, the bench came in and played amazing. So we're happy to see them kind of get some success. But, you know, from the beginning of the game, we felt like we had to come out, push pace, and kind of get some tempo going our way. And so far, we're doing everything that we feel like we need to be doing.
Rebecca, what do you have to do in the second half? We know what you worked on in practice this week, the little things. What do you think has to carry over in the second half?
Oh, yeah. Well, we have to continue to play with energy. We have to continue to try to play our basketball. But, you know, they're a team that's going to try to shoot a lot of threes. You know, they have Tina Charles, who's, of course, going to try to do her thing. But we just have to continue to try to set the tone defensively.
Appreciate it. Thank you, BB.
Yep.
7 first half points for Rebecca Brunson. Minnesota dominated in the paint, led by as many as 19. Coming up, how this team gave back in the nation's capital.
Inside us all beats the heart of an athlete. Determined to succeed. We push. We fight. We sacrifice. Sometimes we fall short. Sometimes we just fall. But we get back up. Stronger than before. This is more than a game. This is our goal.
I know that summers can be hectic. Lynx point guard Lindsay Whelan here to challenge you to improving as a basketball player. The Timberwolves and Lynx Basketball Academy camps are designed to improve your game. Spend part of your summer with our awesome staff. Visit TimberwolvesBasketballAcademy.com for locations near you. Go Lynx!
Slumberland's Dream Team introduces the incredible, livable, adjustable bed. It's more than a bed. It's a livable piece of furniture where all those cozy little ups and downs of life are shared.
Isn't that the guy?
Who sold us our bed?
We've got one for every mattress, all at the lowest price around. Hey, Mortensons. How you doing?
Did he just
wave at us?
The incredible, livable, adjustable bed. Only at Slumberland. It's a good life.
The Lynx scored a season-high 54 points in the first half. They lead the Liberty 54-38. About a week and a half ago, the Lynx played in Washington, in our nation's capital, a game against the Washington Mystics. But they went a day early because they want to make a point of celebrating their 2017 championship, not just by doing something every day. They did something spectacular where they really gave back and made a huge gesture trying to grow the love of the game for the next generation. It was an amazing week of giving for the Lynx.
In a few minutes, a great group of kids are going to be walking in here. We're going to get a chance to wash their feet, put on new shoes, and look them in the eyes and say, one day maybe you're going to be like one of those amazing ladies. Yeah. But regardless of whatever it is that you choose to become, you are already a world champion. And that's what we want them to remember today. So today is going to be about reminding them that they're world champions. We're looking at them in the flesh, but they're going to be future world champions. So we need to pour that into them today.
You guys need to know I've got 7 kids, 6 boys, and 1 daughter. And she is the best athlete on the whole bunch. And you guys are the example. So thank you for everything that you do.
What's up, man? How you doing?
What's your name?
Zayden.
How old are you?
7 years old.
This is awesome. You know, it's moments like these when we can take a minute and step outside of the game while still being inside of the game to make an impact in our communities.
Instead of the extra day off that we would have had, they said we want to go early to Washington and have a day of service. And so, to me, it's just the epitome of what's in their hearts of these players. that they understand how much bigger this is than themselves. And so, you know, for me, it was an incredibly proud day when they popped over and they said, hey, coach, we want to do this. Can you help us? And it's just, it defines them. It's a part of their legacy.
Oh, you got shoes coming.
Got some Jordans.
All right. You got some Nike socks. Let me put these on for you. Then you can put on your shoes. There we go.
But we were trying to figure out a way to really just celebrate who we are as a team and what we've accomplished and what we've done. And I think it's just so beautiful the way that we really just wanted to give and wanted to serve and just interact with kids.
Through becoming champions, we had an opportunity to partner with Samaritan's Feet to have a humanitarian event. To be able to say, we're more than basketball, we're more than basketball players, we're tremendous role models, and we understand the purpose, that it's much, much bigger than us.
Winning four championships has been an amazing accomplishment, but the leadership that you all demonstrate goes beyond the basketball court. And you have celebrated your fourth title today, not by celebrating yourselves, not by a big fancy thing, but by organizing this event to help hundreds of elementary students. To me, that's leadership, and that is being a true champion.
They show us what strength looks like. Now, talent is one thing, and it is great to have talent, but talent doesn't get you very far without hard work and heart. And that is what this team is all about.
We all have a chance in life to build our legacy. The legacy that this group behind me has worked so hard to build is one that goes beyond the court. This group's legacy is that they have used sport as a vehicle of change, empowering and inspiring both women and men, both girls and boys, people of color, the LGBT community, people of faith, and all underserved groups. And for that, I'm incredibly proud. On behalf of Lynx fans everywhere, and on behalf of everyone here, I want to say thank you to these players for being such amazing athletes, incredible role models, and choosing to be here today to show how champions act.
What an amazing group of women and an incredible day for the Lynx and a big halftime lead tonight over the Liberty.
Mom and Dad got a new car with the extra third row seats.
They think it's theirs.
Look at them. They have no idea. It's not theirs. It's mine. Mine.
The new RX350L with three rows for seven passengers.
Are you excited about your baby sister coming?
Experience space for the unexpected with the Lexus RXL, part of the RX family. See Lexus of Wayzata and Lexus of Maplewood. Don't miss the show. Only in Minnesota.
Introducing the Budweiser Freedom Reserve. A limited edition red lager with a light, hoppy aroma, a toasted malt taste, and a hint of molasses. Proudly brewed in support of veterans by Budweiser's own veterans. Available this summer for a limited time only.
Every day, nearly 100 Americans die in car crashes.
Please make it home safe.
25%.
25% of all car crashes involve a cell phone.
Please make it home safe.
This message brought to you by Federated Mutual Insurance Company.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jeff Grayson with your Mall of America Studio Sports Update. It is back to baseball for the Minnesota Twins tomorrow. Join us Sunday at 11:30 as the Twins get ready to take on the Cleveland Indians right here on Fox Sports North. Now back to Lynx basketball.
And, Jeff, it is a 16-point lead for the Lynx at halftime. 54 points is the highest they've scored in a first half this season.
As a Minnesotan, I know that summers can be hectic. Lynx point guard Lindsay Whelan here to challenge you to improving as a basketball player. The Timberwolves and Lynx Basketball Academy camps are designed to improve your game. Spend part of your summer with our awesome staff. Visit TimberwolvesBasketballAcademy.com for locations near you. Go Lynx!
Inside us all beats the heart of an athlete, determined to succeed. We push, we fight, we sacrifice. Sometimes we fall short, sometimes we just fall. But we get back up, stronger than before. This is more than a game. This is our goal.
Hey, Star, do you know about the Rebel?
You think I ain't?
No, not you. The Rebel at Dodge of Burnsville.
Yeah, what's new about him?
Well, it's got an aggressive off-road styling, air ride suspension, cool tread, and awesome seats.
My kind of Rebel.
Right now at the King of Ram, you can get a 2018 Ram Crew Cab Bighorn 4x4 with the Hemi for $12,000 off.
Rebel, Rebel, you tore your dress.
Just
rebel,
go to kingofram.com.
The space is a mess.
Four championships in 7 years.
Maya Moore, nice finish.
There's one word for that. But you think we're content? That we've lost our hunger?
Look at the emotion.
Well, here's three more words for you. And I'm definitely hungry for that.
This team looks motivated tonight.
Watch Lynx basketball all season on Fox Sports North and streaming live on Fox Sports Go.
There's a spot waiting for Neymar, a place at the table next to Pelé, Ronaldo, and Ronaldinho. All he's got to do is put an entire soccer-loving nation on his back.
Neymar! Really?
The same back he broke 4 years ago. No pressure.
This is his moment.
Brazil versus Switzerland. Tomorrow at 1 p.m. Eastern on FS1.
This copyrighted telecast of WNBA Enterprises may not be retransmitted, reproduced, rebroadcast, or otherwise used in any form without the express written consent of WNBA Enterprises.
We are back at the half, and I'm with assistant coach Shelly Patterson. Shelly, the team did a great job in that first half as they started making runs. And can you tell us what the game plan is, though, for the second half?
You know, it's all about the energy that we're providing. We had three great days of practice, and it shows right now. And we had the intention of going out and punching first and continuing to do that in the second half.
Liberty did a great job. 5 3-pointers as they try to mount a comeback. How do you slow them down on the three-point line?
You know what? One of the things we have to do is get closer to our players. So one of the things that we're doing is kind of daring them to shoot. This time we want to force them into the paint, get our defense to collapse, and make them shoot over us.
Coach, thanks for your time.
Thank you.
All right, Marnie, we'll take it back to you.
All right, Leah, there was not a whole lot of things that the Lynx did not do well in that first half. They absolutely dominated in the paint, and they absolutely dominated on the boards. Those were two areas that were completely lopsided or one-sided for Minnesota. Points in the paint went 34-6 in favor of the Lynx. And in the rebounding category, they are third in the WNBA with 36.4 per game. And in this game tonight, leading New York 17-5. New York does not have an offensive rebound and just 5 total rebounds in a half. That's
That's an incredible stat.
Yeah, that's a big stat, and it's exactly what the Lynx needed to happen in this game, because that's about energy, that's about working hard, that's about hustle points when you're rebounding that way.
Lindsay Whalen hits a quick shot on the baseline. Whalen's 2 of 4 from the floor. She played just 9 minutes so far in this game. And then fouls Bria Hartley. Lindsay's just coming back today after missing a day. She was at her grandfather's funeral. There are the rebounds that we talked about. 17-5 offensively. New York does not have one. Minnesota only had 6 points or 6 turnovers in that first half. We mentioned Whalen, who has the basketball. Her grandpa Pinky. I mean, what a great grandpa name. Grandpa Pinky.
That is a great name.
She's an absolute diehard Lynx fan, a huge fan of the WNBA. Just passed away, lived in Grand Forks. And so Lindsay was up in Grand Forks for the funeral this morning and drove back in time for the game today. And said her entire family is together watching the game and, you know, talking about Grandpa Pinky and how he would have been watching and what he would have been yelling at the screen tonight, cheering on his granddaughter right there.
Yeah, it's an emotional time for Lindsay Whalen, what she's gone through and what she's trying to do it by, you know, working the two jobs. And I give her a lot of credit for being able to pull all of that off.
And then still soak in a game plan for the night, you know, and zone in on what you have to do. Good rebound by Fowles, and here is Whalen with the basketball. A steal by Zealous. Zealous to Hartley, back to Zealous for the two.
And that's what's inconsistent right now about this Liberty team, is that when they pass the ball, they make that extra pass or they push the ball up court, they're able to score the ball, but they can go in long periods where they cannot score.
Brunson picked off again, second straight pass picked off. This is Hartley. Good defense by Rebecca Brunson. Good hustle to get back in that play. Tanisha Wright finds Fowles. Still puts it in. 16 points for Sylvia Fowles and 6 rebounds.
It's a big hustle play there.
It eases the pain of back-to-back turnovers just a bit.
It sure does. And it also shows that you don't even necessarily have to touch the ball, but just by having her presence around her, Hartley knew someone was close.
Charles with the long two. Tina Charles with a hand in her face from Brunson. Still hit the shot. Moore waiting for the screen from Brunson. Got the screen, got the shot off. And it rattles in and out. Hartley right down the middle of the court. Picked up by Whalen. Kicks it out. Top of the key. Charles, another 3-point try and another 3-point make. Tina Charles hits from deep, and New York is 6 of 11 from 3, 55%.
Yeah, Minnesota just looked confused on that last set by New York. They pushed the ball down court, and then they just tossed it back, and no one moved defensively to get on Charles.
Another turnover. That's 10 now in the game. The Lynx only had 6 at halftime. Brunson with the rebound. Still dominating on the glass, though. New York has 6 rebounds. Minnesota has 21. And Fowles can't get it to go. Just the second shot that Fowles has missed tonight. She's 7 of 9. Stolen away. Brunson tracks it down.
Brunson is really dialed into this game. She's doing all those little things, and they're needed at this point.
Whalen spins and gets the shot up. Fowles gets the offensive rebound. Sylvia Fowles has 7 rebounds in this game. New York as a team has 7 rebounds in this game.
Yeah, it's amazing what Minnesota has been able to do on the boards. And whenever you have a presence like Sylvia Fowles down low, you're going to get rebounds. But the team as a whole, and then doing a good job blocking out and keeping New York away from the rebounds.
Fowles hits the free throw.
Wells needs three more rebounds for a double-double. Charity has seven double-doubles this year, which leads the WNBA, 134 in her career. Well, free throws has fouls up to 17 points. No other, or 18 now. No other Lynx players in double figures. Maya Moore has 9 points. Hartley makes her move, guarded by Danielle Robinson. Gets free for the shot off the front of the rim. Moore has the rebound. Oh, ouch. Right. Put the elbow right in the face, it looked like, of Bria Hartley. And there was no malicious intent, but yeah, Tanisha Wright was just shuffling from side to side.
Elbow right in the face.
Bria Hartley still on the baseline, but upright.
I'm surprised it didn't knock her down.
I think she got her with the inner part, didn't she? The inner elbow, which is a lot better than that lead elbow.
Take a look at it.
Anytime there is contact to the head or the face, the officials will look at it.
Yep, they're reviewing it. They're just checking the review. The official just came over to let us know that they're checking it, and they'll let us know.
Okay, so the officials will take a look at this. Tanisha Wright was just shuffling the ball from one side to the other here. Now she did get her with that,
yeah,
that first.
Yeah, she sure did.
That right arm as it went through. They'll check to see if it's a flagrant foul, and in that, a flagrant one or two. But no, again, no intent. And I'm not, you know, we don't have a real clear view of where it actually hit Bria Hartley. Danielle Robinson is blocking the view there. So, I mean, by Hartley's reaction, she got hit, but by your reaction, Leah,
yeah, it looked like
you could have knocked her out cold.
Yes, it did.
But it was a glancing blow, thank goodness. So yeah, it wasn't nearly as bad as that could have been. And there's Hartley kind of holding her ear.
Huh.
But the fact that, you know, she didn't lie down on the court. She didn't.
Right. That's what
trip
I was.
And fall, and she just kind of held her own. And but she was holding her left ear on the bench, was she not?
She was just holding her left ear. It did not look
but
like she got
hit her right
ear.
Side.
Yeah. So
I'm gonna let you connect those dots, Leah, and we'll just
maybe now her left ear hurts. I don't know.
Well, she got it on the right side, and you know she felt it all the way through to the left. So this is her right side and her right ear. And I'm not questioning the fact that she at least caught a glancing blow, and to catch anything in the ear or the head is certainly going to be pretty uncomfortable. We don't have that one clear look, though, and that's probably why it's taking the officials so long as well.
Yeah, that's the problem. They're asking for more looks, more looks, more looks, and there's only going to be so many different looks.
And here's one more, since you asked.
The upper.
Huh. Yeah, it certainly doesn't look like there's a whole lot of contact. And here's the official ruling. Offensive foul, common foul, no flagrant. That is the official word from the officials. So we will resume play after all of that, and it will just go as an offensive foul on Tanisha Wright, who now has 2 fouls in this game.
I don't mind at all that the officials go in to do that to try and make sure they get the right call there and seeing if it is a flagrant, if someone gets hit above the shoulders, but it is time-consuming, and it changes the momentum of
a
game.
Yep.
You know, there was a pace to this game, and I'm wondering now if that will return.
And you know, in baseball, when they have a replay like that, they always announce the time. I never hear the time, but that felt like a 3-4 minute lull, and that's the equivalent more than a full timeout. So, but both teams have to sit it out. Both teams have to wait it out. Epiphany Prince pops the 3-pointer off the rim. Brunson rebound.
Brunson is here to play today. She, to me, is the first time looks like the Brunson of old. It's just a solid game by her today.
Moore wide open for a three from the wing. Maya Moore rattles in a three-pointer. Just the second of the game for Minnesota. First for Maya tonight.
Conversation in the WNBA about the team moving to three, the league moving to a league that's a three-point shooting league like the NBA.
There are a lot of teams trending in that direction. You see a lot of three-point shots, more so than before. Sylvia fouls, hacked on the way to the basket. 20 points for fouls after that basket. 8 of 10 from the floor with 7 rebounds. And now the lead is back up to 20. Moore hits a three, and Fowles has a chance at three when we come back.
I grew up in Miami with three older brothers and an older sister. They definitely pushed me towards basketball, and they helped me get better.
How do you stop Sylvia Fowles?
I was eager to learn because I always wanted to impress. It just made me a better person. I always felt like I can do anything. That's just that drive that keeps me going. Like, how can I be better than I was last year?
Denied by Sylvia Fowles.
I'm here to work.
Slumberland's Dream Team introduces the incredible, livable, adjustable bed. It's more than a bed. It's a livable piece of furniture where all those cozy little ups and downs of life are shared.
Isn't that the guy?
Who sold us our bed?
We've got one for every mattress, all at the lowest price around.
Hey, Mortensen. How you doing?
Did he just
wave at us?
The incredible, livable, adjustable bed. Only at Slumberland. It's a good life.
Points here in the third quarter over the New York Liberty. When you combine the most provocative man in sports with the most interesting man in sports, you get opinion that cuts through the hype. Catch Speak for Yourself with Colin Cowherd and Jason Whitlock weekdays at 4 p.m. Central, only on FS1. Sylvia Fowles is at the free throw line trying to convert on what would be a three-point play. Sylvia tonight in the paint is 7 of 9 for 14 points. She has one long two that she hit, and she is 5 of 5 from the free throw line. How about that for a 21.7 rebound night, Leah, with still a quarter plus to play?
Well, and her points, I mean, they come after getting beat up. You know, when you have two and three players pushing you and knocking you around, they're not easy points. So, well-deserved by Sylvia Fowles.
An offensive foul on Kia Stokes, setting a screen. And the Liberty has been called for a few offensive fouls tonight. Off-ball fouls. And that was on Minnesota. So now, back and forth we go. That was Rebecca Brunson being called for that foul. Brunson's third.
See if we can get a little bit of flow back into this game.
Brittany Boyd with the basketball. This is just the fifth game of the season for Boyd. Missed almost all of last season with a torn Achilles. Now Epiphany Prince. It's the screen from Stokes. But the steal by Rebecca Brunson. Zandala CEO. put some language on that pass, but couldn't quite get it into Sylvia Fowles.
I like the thought of it, though. I don't think Coach Reeve does, but I like the thought that she's feeling comfortable enough to, you know, make a fancy pass or look and you know, do something that isn't scripted. She hasn't had a lot of time, and they have a lot of high expectations for her.
Yep, she's 22 years old. Cecilia Zandalassini goes by Chechi, and she is seeing her role increase in the last couple of weeks with the Lynx. Offensive rebound, a rare one. Corral, just the second of the game. Stokes had it. Stokes missed the shot. Zandalassini had the rebound, and Prince came in to tie her up.
Great hustle by the Liberty. They were working.
There's two offensive rebounds and nine total in the game for New York.
That is an aggressive play right there.
Tiffany Prince at 5'9 will jump against Zandalassini at 6'1. Cheryl Reeve is making sure everyone is in the right spots on the court. Prince taps it twice. Danielle Robinson grabs the basketball. Nice pass. Timmy Fake-Bentley kicked it out to Maya Moore. Could not get that friendly bounce. And there's a foul. That was Tina Charles trying to get position for the rebound. That is four on Charles. Tina Charles just 10 points and two rebounds in this game. She averages 22, tied for the league lead.
Yeah, the Lynx have done a tremendous job in holding her down in this game. And the Liberty rely on her so much for scoring production, and she has to take a lot of shots to get it.
Moore just puts that nice, soft touch, gets the arc on the shot.
Quick release.
14 points for Moore. Prince, top of the key. Guarded closely by Zandalassini. Zowie B. Fake-Bentley has the rebound. A couple of dribbles, gives it up to Robinson. Two fouls. Zowie B. Fouled Sylvia.
Definitely better communication in this game for the Minnesota League Lynx as how they're moving the ball, passing it to one another, seeing when to get it into Sylvia Fowles. Just much better than we've seen in particular in the last three or four games.
Much better everything, it seems like. The Lynx needed a break. They needed, and I know we're not that deep into the schedule, just nine games for Minnesota, but to go 3-6, to have lost 4 of 5, to have been on the road for that long stretch and coming home for one and then right back on the road, it got to be a lot in a hurry. And they were playing good teams. The East is good this year.
Yes, they are.
Washington and Connecticut, and, you know, losing a couple of heartbreakers in there, that loss to Atlanta. They needed something different. They needed 2 days off and 3 days of a mini training camp.
Yeah,
exactly what they got this week.
It was just right. And we know that this season, that because it is shorter, the Lynx being the oldest team in the league, that's going to be harder
for
them.
Most experienced team.
Right.
That's the way we're wording that. Kia Nurse, who's been really quiet in this game, is fouled. She has not scored yet. Nurse averages 13 points per game. And Nurse will be at the free throw line for the first time tonight. Lynx fans, for the first time in league history, the WNBA All-Star Game will be hosted at Target Center July 28th. Be there to see the best of the best put on a show right here in our territory. This is one game you won't want to miss, so visit lynxbasketball.com to lock in your seats now. Nurse hits both from the free throw line, which ended a 10-0 Minnesota run. And now the key for Minnesota will be to keep the pressure on. And that'll help. Two more from Sylvia Fowles, who's up to 23.
Great pass down low, dumps right in behind the defense, and still has no problem laying that one in.
And a nice pass and a nice finish. Kia Nurse, who had not scored, just made two at the free throw line and another two there after New York had missed nine consecutive shots. Nurse gets four consecutive points.
even though Nurse has not had a big game, she does not look like a rookie to me. She doesn't play that way at all.
End to end, Brittany Boyd never picked up the dribble. There are a technical foul. A tech was called on Brittany Boyd. Brittany Boyd for New York is whistled for the tech at a really odd time. We're going to have to go back and figure what happened. Brittany Boyd, number 15, she went end to end. I don't know if she maybe wanted a foul call. And this is the official on the baseline that called that tech. So behind Boyd to her back. I think she was surprised to get it, but
yeah, I think it was a quick couple of words and she's thinking she was out of there.
The right words. The trigger words.
She wasn't.
Xander Lassini will shoot the technical free throw and make it. And now Katie Smith is arguing her points. Arms crossed, looking for an explanation from the official. Katie is a demonstrative player. You know what? She was, or a coach, she was such a fiery player. She was absolutely intense. And she is a coach that way. She is still barking at officials.
Well, I'm so happy she stayed in the game, has become a head coach in this league. That's just such a good sign for the WNBA, getting experienced players moving into those coaching positions.
Xander Lassini for three. That looked good right out of her hands. Chechi, Xander Lassini with a career-high 10 points. She's 4 of 5 from the floor.
It is her breakout game, and it looks good.
Chechi is in her second season from Italy. Did not see much playing time. Didn't play the entire season last year. Just 3 regular season games and 5 postseason games. She's been a big part of what the Lynx have been doing lately.
And she's that player that they're saying is the player of the future for the WNBA. About 6'1", 2", can play a couple different positions, stretch a defense. I think that's why the Lynx were so excited to get her in here.
She can run, she can shoot, that kind of play.
Yeah, like a Taurasi.
Against Connecticut last Saturday, Chechi played 12, almost 13 minutes. Just 1 of 3 from the field, but 8 of 8 from the free throw line. So 8 of her 11 points came at the line. This is Rebecca Allen at the free throw line. Allen's a fourth-year player out of Australia. Hits them both. Good effort by Danielle Robinson as the third quarter comes to a close. The Lynx are shooting 54% from the field. And they have a big lead to start the fourth quarter at Target Center.
Introducing the Budweiser Freedom Reserve, a limited edition red lager with a light hoppy aroma, a toasted malt taste, and a hint of molasses. Proudly brewed in support of veterans by Budweiser's own veterans. Available this summer for a limited time only.
The best of the best go head-to-head on the biggest night of the summer. What a night! The MLB All-Star Game, July 17th on Fox.
I had probably every single odd against me that I would make it to this point. I had nothing handed to me. The story is not over. I'm not done.
Are you as hungry today as you were 10 years ago?
Probably hungrier.
Enjoy Twins baseball with the whole family and the alcohol-free Cub Family section presented by Fox Sports North. Tickets include a free Schweigert hot dog and a Pepsi. For details, visit foxsportsnorth.com/events.
On Pride Night at Target Center. They've led by as many as 23, but the Lynx have not done a great job this season of closing out games, and even further than that, just playing in the second halves. They have not had great third quarters or fourth quarters and have allowed their opponents to close the gap, sometimes finish off a game. But that has not been the case so far tonight. That was an excellent third quarter for the Lynx, where they increased their lead. A five-point advantage for Minnesota in the third quarter, which it was a trend that needed to start going in the other direction.
And it was something that, you know, we really haven't seen from the Minnesota Lynx except for this season. And so it was very troubling. And it was hard to pinpoint what exactly. I mean, the biggest thing everyone talked about was the turnovers. And that was evident in particular in the L.A. games. But there was other pieces that I think got resolved in practice this week. And it was the smaller pieces of the energy and the diving and communicating that they just weren't doing.
Tina Charles missed the open shot. Brittany Boyd gets called for the foul, her first in the game tonight. Danielle Robinson, who's played 16 minutes in this game. She has 4 points. That backcourt has really been vital for Minnesota. Lindsay Whalen playing some limited minutes. Another offensive foul. And that was on Temi Fegh-Bendley. Offensive foul. The officials don't like the screens that have been set tonight. Boyd, Sugar. Rogers misses and ping pong. The ball goes out of bounds and it'll be Minnesota basketball. The Lynx need to finish this quarter strong. Alexis Jones to Moore. Moore top of the key. Three-pointer.
Another big difference in this Lynx team is perimeter players hitting big shots, three-point shots, being effective so you can stretch that defense.
That was the second three of the game for Maya Moore. And Boyd got around the corner. That was an odd play because Danielle Robinson raised her hand like she committed the foul and the official didn't call the foul. So we play on. Okay. Okay. Moore again. That one's just a little short, though. I feel like even when Moore misses a shot, it has such a great chance because of the arc and the rotation and the touch that she puts on her shots. They just, even when they hit the rim, you have to keep watching because that thing might drop through.
Well, I would like to see Maya Moore's shot attempts go up, and I think in particular at the start of games, because if she gets rolling right away, it can just change the whole way that the team goes.
She's taken 14 shots so far in this game tonight. Jones, she wanted it the first time, had to get free, but then is blocked. Boyd. Zanda Lassini picks up the foul. That is her first. Live coverage of the final round of the 118th U.S. Open is tomorrow from Shinnecock Hills on Fox, FS1, and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. Boyd weaving her way. Charles again from three. Tina Charles has shot it from deep a few times tonight. 2 of 4 from three. Alexis Jones. Now Moore. Sylvia follows back and forth with Tanisha Wright. Wright. Three-pointer. Rolled around. That looked like it was going in.
I feel like Wright has been unlucky with her shots in that way. She's had good looks, shots that have almost gone in.
Rebecca Allen, two. Front foot was ahead of the line. And Tanisha Wright is one of five with 3 points and three rebounds, but she certainly played an effective game. And she started tonight in place of Simone Augustus. But Wright is not necessarily out there to score. She's out there to play defense and to be a leader, a veteran leader for Minnesota.
Right.
Well, they're dancing at Target Center, and they have every reason to, with a 20-point lead, 6:54 to play.
The heart of an athlete, determined to succeed. We push, we fight, we sacrifice. Sometimes we fall short, sometimes we just fall, but we get back up, stronger than before. This is more than a game. This is our goal.
General, the Lynx have 30 to New York's 17.
That is probably a coach's favorite stat, because that just talks about effort and hustle and working to get the ball. That is exactly what we've seen from the Lynx today.
The fewest rebounds that the Lynx have allowed all time is 17, and that was at Indiana, 18 against Phoenix, and right now New York is sitting on 17. But that's actually a pretty good recovery, because the Liberty had five at halftime, right? Five or six.
Yep.
I got to check, find my halftime box, which I threw away. Five. Mike Greenbaum, our statistician, is telling us five rebounds at halftime.
That's amazing. That seems almost impossible. Unless you're shooting the ball so well.
Right, like 85%, which New York was not. Tina Charles now has five personal fouls. And Danielle Robinson will come in. Alexis Jones to the bench.
One of the things that Coach Reeve wants from Jones is her to push the pace a little bit better. She's a little bit lackadaisical when she's out there kind of pushing it down court. Coach Reeve wants her to get up and down that court and get them right into their offense.
Moore trying to lose Sugar Rogers, finally gets the screen from Sylvia Fowles to do so, but then Rogers has the rebound. Hartley. Rhea Hartley give and go. And the basket from Charles, who continues to play with five personal fouls.
And very quiet in this game for Tina Charles, I should say.
Yep, 12 points, four rebounds. Again, she averages 22 points per game, tied for the league lead with Skylar Diggins-Smith.
Battling down low, you know, for most of the game against Brunson and Fowles, so nothing easy down there.
Outlet pass to Kia Nurse.
And it wasn't long ago we were talking about Nurse being held scoreless. She has 6 points. Cheryl Reeve would talk things over, wants to clean things up, even with the big lead. 8-0 in the Liberty run. Finish out strong, finish out a clean half. They led by as many as 24. New York just went on an 8-0 run. Tanisha Wright has it stolen away, and that's not what Reeve wanted to see right out of the timeout. And then Robinson and Hartley get tangled up.
Yeah, I am so impressed with Kia Hartley. Yeah, Kia Hartley. Just watching her play, and I've watched her play in all of their games this season, and she is so effective in her way of getting to the basket, attacking the basket, turning you over. She's good from the free throw line, and she's great from the three-point line.
Nurse will inbound. Rogers with it. Charles says she traveled. We'll play on. Rogers tries to kick it out. Here's Charles again. Tina Charles moves in for the closer shot. Brunson with the rebound. And now the Lynx need a good possession here. They have 15 turnovers in this game, and they average just over 15, about 15 and a half per game. That is the highest number in the WNBA, and it's been a point of emphasis, but something that the Lynx just have not been able to successfully clean up. Robinson did not take the three-point shot. She was there and had a chance. And that is something we're still waiting to see, is Danielle Robinson to hit a three. She has played, this is her seventh year in the WNBA. And Robinson is 0-36 in her career in three-pointers. She has taken three this year. She's 0-3. And at the beginning of the season, Cheryl Reeve said, Danielle Robinson will hit a three-pointer this season.
Well, it would help. It definitely would help if she could do that, but...
Well, if she was so hesitant to even shoot it.
Right,
there.
Exactly. And she just has to be comfortable shooting the ball. Does not have to be.
The side act going on here is the Lynx only had four players on the court.
Lindsay Whelan trying to get into the game, but they hadn't allowed her in yet.
Lindsay ran to the scorer's table. I don't know if you could hear her. I thought you heard her on her microphone. She said, hey, I sprinted. And Cheryl Reeve said to someone in the crowd, thanks for your help, because somebody in the crowd yelled, you need another player. You only have four. Okay, so we had a light moment. And the Lynx can do that with a 16-point lead, but they cannot let New York make this a game here in the final 4:15. Charles puts it on the deck, kicks it out. Nurse open for three. Big miss, but a big rebound. Nearly rebound by Rebecca Allen. Minnesota safely with the basketball now, but the Lynx have missed 7 consecutive shots. Zandalicini drives. Offensive foul on Chechi. That's number 2 on Zandalicini. The second in the quarter for Minnesota. Whalen is back in. She did make it to the scores table. They did allow her in.
They sure did. And she talked to the coaches while she's getting in, asking what they want her to run. And
Amanda Zowie B sets a hard screen. And she's whistled for the foul. Zowie B has 3. There have been a lot of fouls on screens in this game. Sandalacini.
Wow.
That was, I mean, that was like she was planted in cement for how
it looked like it
heavy
hurt.
That was.
Sandalacini didn't seem the least bit affected.
Tough player.
Yes, she is.
3.5 minutes left to play at Target Center. In a game that Minnesota has led nearly end-to-end, Brunson, a late whistle as the ball rolled off the rim. New York led 1-0. Or I should say 1-0. New York had a 1-point lead. Other than that, it's been complete domination by the Lynx. Brunson has had a nice game, 7 points, 6 rebounds, 1 assist, but a missed free throw. Right about her average, too. Rebecca averages 7.7 rebounds. Second one is short. Zowie B for the rebound, and Maya Moore went in. Too physical. Referees are calling this one tight.
I had anticipated that the Liberty would come in here and give the Lynx better run than this, and I, after their loss to the Las Vegas Aces, I thought that they were going to come in and pay back someone for that loss.
But turnover by New York. And that was a tough loss for New York because Katie Smith is the head coach because Bill Laimbeer left to become the head coach of the Las Vegas Aces, formerly San Antonio Stars.
I like how Bill Laimbeer said, well, I knew every play that was being called on both teams.
Fouls with the left hand. Up to 25 points. The Lynx had not scored in 6 minutes before that basket by Sill. Rogers. 3 off the rim. And a foul on Lindsey Whalen. Well, it's either fouls on screens or just off-ball fouls. It's been an odd kind of game. And it hasn't been as much the shooting fouls as it has been something off-ball. 2:50 left to play at Target Center.
I grew up in Miami with 3 older brothers and an older sister. They definitely pushed me towards basketball, and they helped me get better.
How do you stop Sylvia Fowles?
I was eager to learn because I always wanted to impress. It just made me a better person. I always felt like I can do anything. That's just that drive that keeps me going. Like, how can I be better than I was last year?
Denied by Sylvia Fowles.
I'm here to work.
As a Minnesotan, I know that summers can be hectic. Lynx point guard Lindsey Whalen here to challenge you to improving as a basketball player. The Timberwolves and Lynx Basketball Academy camps are designed to improve your game. Spend part of your summer with our awesome staff. Visit TimberwolvesBasketballAcademy.com for locations near you. Go Lynx!
New York by 18 with 2 minutes and 50 seconds left to play. The Lynx trying to right the ship here, and they are doing it against a first-year head coach in Katie Smith, who spent 7 seasons with the Lynx, was the first legitimate star that Minnesota had. She basically led the team in every important statistical category. Then won 2 championships when she left Minnesota and went to Detroit. Played for the Detroit Shock, played for Bill Laimbeer, and Cheryl Reeve was an assistant coach for those 2 titles. And the former player and coach met before the game, and it was funny to listen to Cheryl Reeve. She said Katie Smith always said, I never want to coach. And Katie said, yeah, I didn't. I had no desire to be a coach. And here she is. She was an assistant for New York, then the associate head coach last year, and now the head coach.
Yeah, when she was with the Minnesota Lynx as a player, she was getting ready to go to dental school.
Yes, that's right.
I was going to make her my dentist, and now I don't
know. You don't want her anywhere near your team right now.
But it's so funny that she wouldn't want to be a coach because she feels like a coach to me. She
like
looks
basketball
like a coach.
Just oozes through
yes,
her, too.
Exactly.
Epiphany Prince with the three-pointer. The seventh New York has hit tonight, 7 of 19. Fouls in all kinds of traffic. How does she even get the shot off?
I don't know how she does it. Game in and game out, just the beating she takes down low.
Pass too strong for Amanda Zawidi. Fouls has a season high of 25 points, still sitting on 9 rebounds. One more would give her another double-double. Would be her 8th of the season to lead the league. Trying to get position. There'll be a foul on New York. The yell you heard was from Sylvia Fouls. I don't know what that was all about, but that's how I knew where the foul came, was based on the yelp that she let out of trying to get position for that ball. 14 fouls on the Liberty, 4 also for Minnesota, so we'll be seeing bonus free throws if there are more fouls. Zanna Lissini, cross court to Moore, open for 3. Maya Moore hits the 3-pointer. That should all but seal this game if New York had any thoughts of a comeback. 20 points now for Maya. Allen. One dribble and straight to the rack.
Attacks the basket well, gets there with a lot of finesse.
But how big is that 3 for Moore, just in the fact that this would now be a 13-point game? And, yeah, that seems unlikely, but, you know, coaches play until the very final whistle. Now you have this little more breathing room here after the 3. Let's get 3 more. Brunson in and out.
Let's remember the last time we played New York and Maya hit another big 3-point shot.
Rebound to Moore. Rebounding has evened out a little bit. Now Minnesota with 33, New York 22, but that's actually a lot closer than it was for most of the game. Moore kicks it out to Brunson one more time. Still can't get it. 1 minute to go. Sylvia Fouls will be joining us right after the game, so stick around to hear from Syl. Whalen gets Chichi. A breakout game, 13 points for Chechi.
Lindsay Whalen wanted to make sure that she was going to get that ball and hit that big shot.
The Lynx will just let Amanda Zawidi go in. And the Lynx will call a timeout to get some subs into the game, get the starters off the court. And look at the reception that Zanna Lissini gets from Simone Augustus in the bench.
Yeah, just unselfish basketball there by Lindsay Whalen. Getting the ball to Zanna Lissini, knowing that she's waiting and wanting her to continue this big night. Simone's having a good old time over there.
The bench reactions from the Lynx last year into this year, especially last year with Plenette Pearson.
Oh, yeah.
Just, like, she would lead some of the dances she would do on the sideline. It was like, as soon as a basket was scored, you had to look at the bench to see what the reaction would be. Chechi Zanna Lissini is 5 of 6 in this game, 13 points, season high, career high. I have the feeling we'll be seeing a lot more of Chechi as the Lynx move forward here. Second-year player out of Italy. Feg Benley. All starters are clear now. Off the court for the final 20 seconds. Feg Benley lost it. Allen spots up, spots in.
Allen has looked good in there for the minutes that she's getting in this game.
Yeah, Rebecca Allen has a nice-looking shot. 7 seconds will wind it down. The Lynx will improve to 4-6. And while that doesn't sound all that great, it is a huge turn in the right direction. Minnesota could still be there in the end. I believe this team has the talent and the depth to still be a contender when it comes to the final series of the season. I think Minnesota will still be there, and winning this game tonight against New York is a big part of the Lynx getting themselves straightened out. A big win over New York. Sylvia Fowles will join us next.
Every day, nearly 100 Americans die in car crashes.
Please make it home safe.
25%
of all car crashes involve a cell phone.
Please make it home safe.
This message brought to you by Federated Mutual Insurance Company.
Mom and Dad got a new car with the extra third row seats.
They think it's theirs.
Look at them. They have no idea.
It's not theirs. It's mine.
The new RX350L with 3 rows for 7 passengers.
Are you excited about your baby sister coming?
Experience space for the unexpected with the Lexus RXL, part of the RX family. See Lexus of Wayzata and Lexus of Maplewood.
Our favorite moments aren't measured in time. They're measured in belly aches, the number of tangles in your hair, constellations, oohs, ahs, butterflies, and bravery. Measure your moments differently. Only in Minnesota.
4 championships in 7 years.
Maya Moore, nice finish.
There's one word for that. But you think we're content? That we've lost our hunger?
Look at the emotion.
Well, here's 3 more words for you. And I'm definitely hungry for that.
This team looks motivated tonight.
Watch Lynx basketball all season on Fox Sports North and streaming live on Fox Sports Go.
Do you want to make watching the FIFA World Cup even better? All you have to do is click. With the new Fox Sports app, streaming every match from anywhere you are is easy, because this is your personal nerve center for everything FIFA World Cup, reminding you what's on and when, giving you multiple angles of the match so you won't miss a moment. And you can impress your friends with the FIFA World Cup highlight machine sponsored by Adidas. Take the FIFA World Cup everywhere you go with the new Fox Sports app. Download it today.
The Lynx are celebrating on their home court for the first time in a couple of weeks after a 14-point win over the New York Liberty. Sylvia Fowles at 25 points, 9 rebounds, and joins us right now. That was a good win. That was a needed win. How nice was it to come out and see the response from so many different players the way you guys stepped on the court and played here tonight?
Well, it started at practice this week. I think we had a good week of practice, and we drilled a lot of things that we normally do that we haven't did through that 9-game stretch. So we just try to come out and utilize those things, and I think everybody contributed tonight who stepped on the floor.
Talk about the bench players, because that was so fun to see so many different players step up, and especially Zandra Lassini, though. She was in her own little whatever there, just
groove. We call it the hot spot. But she's been lighting it up in practice, and I think everybody was focused tonight, and we just try to come out here and make it our business, just to go out and be aggressive and have fun doing it. We haven't seen that in our 9-game stretch, and we kind of got away from it. But when we bring that energy on defense, offense just comes easy.
You guys brought energy on offense, defense, you mentioned, but it was the rebounding. It was the going after loose balls. We saw bodies on the floor. That was the energy that I'm guessing that you guys needed to tap into a little bit, and you brought it all out here tonight.
That's what we're good at. When we're in action like that and everybody's moving, everybody helping each other out, it don't matter where you at on the floor. We just make sure we keep moving and having that extra energy, and we get good results when we do that.
Sylvia, what do you take from this game now to move forward? I know you don't get a lot of time to enjoy these games, but how do you take this into the next game?
We feed off it for tonight. Probably rest up a little bit for tomorrow and get ready for Tuesday. We got to refocus and regroup because we got a different team coming in.
Well, this was a big step in the right direction. Great game tonight. So
thank you,
Mom. Congrats on the win. Season high, 25 points for Sylvia Fowles to go along with the 9 rebounds. A big win tonight for the Lynx. They needed this one. They needed to play the way that they played tonight. So that'll do it tonight from Target Center, where the Lynx beat the Liberty by 14, 85-71. The Lynx will return to Fox Sports North Plus on July 13th at 7 o'clock when they host the Las Vegas Aces. For Leah Bielsen and our entire Fox Sports North crew, including our producer, Peter Anderson, tonight, I'm Marty Gellner saying goodnight from Minneapolis, where the Lynx beat the New York Liberty by 14, 85-71.